One of the behavioral and psychological symptoms of dementia is apathy. And apathy is defined as a lack of interest and a lack of motivation in a person. So a person who has apathy doesn't have as much interest in their surroundings, may not have interest in interacting with their environment or other people, and they have a lack of initiative and a lack of motivation. They don't feel like doing things. They don't see a point necessarily. And it's not volitional. It's not like they say, oh, I just want to lie here. They just don't have any motivation. And that could happen in dementia. We know that there's a part of the brain, the front part of the brain, there's a certain tract that eventually could be affected by dementia, especially if someone has frontotemporal dementia or strokes in the frontal part of the brain, the front part. But even in Alzheimer's disease, people could develop apathy. And it could be very distressing for people. It's associated with reduced quality of life for the patient, for the caregiver, reduced function, disability. So it has its effects, and it can be very, very distressing for people to see someone who is always active now just not want to do anything at all. So for example, if you have a husband and a wife, and the husband has apathy as a result of dementia, and my wife might want to help the person get up, get dressed, and go to a day program, the apathy could be very hard to deal with. The person just doesn't feel like it necessarily. So it could be very distressing. So it's different than the other types of behaviors where there's risk of violence or aggression, screaming, calling out, hoarding, and wandering. Those types of behaviors, especially in the long-term care facility, can cause lots of problems for the environment. It distresses everybody, including the person who has the behaviors. Apathy could go unnoticed, but it has negative consequences. So it should be dealt with in some way. So the evidence for apathy is, again, pharmacological and non-pharmacological. So in terms of the non-medication treatments, there's been lots of interventions. Again, there's lots of research with non-pharmacological interventions in dementia. For apathy, it appears that therapeutic activities could be helpful. There's not a very strong body of evidence about which particular one, but some sort of structured activity could be very helpful. The problem is that once those activities stop, the person may continue to have apathy. So you might have an intervention that lasts a week or so, and then once it's stopped, the person will go back to how they were. So what does this mean? This means that for people who are dealing with family members or clients who have apathy, having them busy with activities, again, is very important. And it will get them at least active so that they could maintain a certain degree of function. It could be hard, and caregivers need support because they might feel like, well, this is laziness, or this is being done on purpose because it's negative towards me and it stresses me out. It isn't. It's a brain dysfunction. So it's very challenging, and it requires teamwork and requires a good strategy. But the therapeutic activities appears to be the way to go in terms of non-pharmacological intervention. In terms of medications, there's not a lot of research. The best evidence is for acetylcholinesterase inhibitors. And those are the medications that are used usually for the memory problems in dementias. So for example, Alzheimer's disease, there's medications such as donepezil, galantamine, rivastigmine. These are medications that boost the brain chemical acetylcholine to try and symptomatically deal with the dementia in terms of memory loss and function. So lots of people are already on those medications if they have dementia. So if someone's not on that medication, that would be the first line currently for treating apathy in dementia. But lots of people are already on it. So if someone's already on an acetylcholinesterase inhibitor, then what to do? Or if that medication is not working or not tolerated, then what to do? There's some evidence about stimulants. Stimulants, for example, methylphenidate or Ritalin. Often that's given to people with attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, ADD. But there's some evidence that medication could be used to, I guess, stimulate, it's a stimulant, to give someone the energy and initiative to start doing things. They're not without their risks, though. They're stimulants. Think of drinking many strong cups of coffee. It can make you nervous or irritable. You could get a rapid heart rate or an increase in blood pressure. So there are certain warnings that need to be discussed with the person who's giving consent for the medications, but there is some evidence that those medications could be helpful.